Welcome to another session of Wireless Communication and Networks, Unit 4, Equalization, Diversity. The second topic of fourth unit is training a generic adaptive equalizer. That is general adaptive equalizer, how it works in a receiver section. Here, see, this figure shows exactly how the basic linear equalizer during a training. Already we discussed about in previous session, right? Y of t is the output signal, which contains input signal plus noise. Once we are getting output is Y of t, which is given to equalizer. The output of the equalizer given to Bayesian circuit. After Bayesian circuit, we are getting reconstruct signal. Similarly, the adaptive equalizer is a time-varying filter. An adaptive equalizer is a time-varying filter which must constantly to be returned. That is, whenever it is not matched, automatically the signal is returned back due to positive feedback. Here, this figure shows exactly how adaptive equalizer works. Here, in this figure shows the subscript K is denotes discrete time index. Right. See, this is now I am explaining how it works exactly. Suppose first we have to take original signal Y of K. Apply inverse Z transform. That is why we are going for like this, nothing but we have to represent the output signal in terms of coefficients. That is, the equalizer works as a filter, right? We have to represent filter coefficients. That's why we have to take the first is Y of K, the second is Y of K minus 1, the third is Y of K minus 2 up to Y of K minus N. These are filter coefficients. Suppose first, I take only Y of K is the input signal. Then automatically that Y of K is directly given to first weight is W of 0K. The weights are W of 1K, W of 2K, like to W of NK. First of all, we are giving the first one is there is no weight. That is W of 0K, that is there is no weight. Directly whatever output Y of K given, that directly given to decision summation, decision circuit. That is equalizer. Here the first of all we are getting output is D K of cap is the output of the equalizer. Then which is given to decision circuit. The decision circuit compare Y of K with DK. DK is nothing but XK. Just we have to assume that here in this figure, DK, which is equivalent to XK of the input signal. XK and DK should be equal. Just compare YK and DK, whether it is equal, directly we are giving output. Otherwise, it shows error. That is the difference between YK and DK equal to zero. Nothing but there is no problem. Whether the difference between YK and DK is we are getting output is it is not equal, or that we are getting error signal. That's why, again, we go into feedback to adaptive algorithm with update each weight. They can again change the weight. Next, go for the second one. Again, second one, the weight is changed and the pulse width also can be changed. That is pulses positions also change due to YK minus one. Then move to the, again output of equalizer, again comparison. Whether it is equal, no problem. Or not equal, again go for it shows error, again go for adaptive algorithm. That is, each and every time when it is not matched with input signal, output is not matched with input signal, we have to change the weights. Like a simple balance, already we discussed. Suppose I go for a grocery store, they check the balance of your grocery with along with scale up to match, both should be matched. If it is not matched, change the weights. Similarly here also, to reduce eye inter-symbol interference, and match with input and output, we have to change the weights. This is about adaptive equalizer. Adaptive equalizer. From this figure, I will go for the mathematical explanation. Here, before going to mathematical explanation, how the weights are can be changed. How the weights can be changed. Here, these weights can be changed based upon the algorithm like least mean square algorithm, which is used for change the near optimum weights. Near optimum filter weights. Suppose we go for grocery store. Suppose it is 600 grams your grocery, but we want 1 kg. Nothing but again we have to put some grocery up to nearly matching to 1 kg. Likewise, what is the new weight? We have to add new weight, which is equal to previous weight plus constant multiplied with previous error. How much error we are getting? We want 1 kg, but we are put only 600 grams. What is the error we are getting? 400 grams is the error. That's why constant is multiplied with previous error multiplied with current input vector. That is about new weight. Here, what is the previous error? Nothing but previous desired output minus previous actual output. Previous desired output minus previous actual output. This is how new weights can be comes. Here, the other names for this adaptive equalizer algorithms are nothing but blind algorithms. Why it is called the blind algorithms? Nothing but which is nothing but this equalizers through a property of restorer techniques of the transmitted signal. That is, we have to restore the original transmitted signal by applying the equalization. That is called the blind algorithm. Let's say blindly we have to check the balance of the weights. What is the input and output? That's like the blind algorithm. The other algorithms, the same one we also call as the constant modulus algorithm, CME algorithm, or it is also called the spectral coherence restoral algorithm, SCORE. Like the different names are there for these adaptive equalization algorithms. Right here, based upon this figure two, the vector y of k input signal to equalizer. What is the input signal for the equalizer? The output of the communication system is input to the equalizer. That is yk, which is equal to yk minus 1, yk minus 2 up to yk minus 1 power of transpose. Here, what is the output of the equalizer is dk cap, which is equal to, we are taking n inputs with respect to n weights. That's why summation n equal to 0 to capital N WNK YK minus N. Here, what is meant by WK weights? Vector weight, that is W of 0K, W of 1K, W of QK up to W of NK transpose. From this equation, automatically you can be written as 789 DK cap, which is equal to YK transpose multiplied with WK. Otherwise, it is called as a WK transpose multiplied with YK. Here, how to calculate error signal, whether the signal is error or not. That is, the output of the equalizer matched with input signal. What is the output of the equalizer is D cap of K. And what is the input signal is DK, or it is called the XK, whatever it may be. That is EK, which is equal to DK minus DK cap. Otherwise, it is called the XK minus DK cap. Just substitute equation number 10 in equation number 11. Then EK, which is equal to XK minus YK of transpose WK. XK minus YK transpose WK. Then which is equal to XK minus WK transpose YK. Suppose in how to represent the error signal, it is in terms of mean squared error, or it has a variance. That is modulus of EK square, which is equal to XK square plus, that is A minus B whole square, that is XK square plus WK transpose YK, YK transpose WK minus 2 into XK YK transpose WK. This is the representation of error signal by using this adaptive equalizer. Right. Now, exactly calculate the variance for this error signal, that is expectation of EK square, what is something which is equal to expectation of XK square plus WK transpose expectation of YK, YK transpose WK minus two expectation of XK, YK transpose WK. This shows the variance of a error signal. Suppose we have to apply the cross correlation between input signal and output signal. Here, what is meant by correlation in signal processing? Nothing but matching. How much up to how much it can be matched together. That is, here we have to compare with input and output. Input is X of K, output is Y of K. That's why the cross correlation vector P, which is equal to expectation of XK, YK, which is equal to expectation of XK, YK, XK, YK minus 1, XK, YK, YK minus 2 up to XK, YK minus n transpose, which shows correlation matrix. After this one, how exactly the R matrix, that is input covariance matrix. What is my input covariance matrix? That what is the input for equalizer? That is, what is the input for equalizer is YK. What is my covariance? Nothing but original signal multiplied with complex conjugate. That's why capital R, which is equal to expectation of YK into YK star, which is equal to expectation of that matrix shows. Here in this matrix, see this one. All the diagonal matrix are squared. All the diagonal matrix are squared with respect to input signal. Input signal. Finally, we are calculating based upon the elements of R and P. R is nothing but input covariance matrix. P is nothing but correlation matrix. The final mean squared error, how much, which is equal to expectation of X square plus W transpose R omega minus 2PT transpose of weight W. If from this figure, W value, which is the weight vector, the weight vector should be changed up to the transmitted signal and receiver signal should be matched together by using this adaptive equalizer technique. This is about adaptive equalizer, generic adaptive equalizer, how the generic adaptive equalizer works with respect to weights. Do you have any query, type your query in a chat box. Thank you very much for attending today's session.